Hi, everybody. Welcome to Spanish, Teaching Spanish in Second Life with Martha Eugenia Lino Acosta. First, I'm going to read her biography and say hi to her because she's here in the classroom. And thank you all for coming. And then we're going to be decamping to Spanish with Eugenia, her spot where she teaches in Second Life for the presentation. So, her biography, let me read it. It's Martha Eugenia Lino Acosta, graduated from Universidad Nacional Autónoma of Mexico, or UNAM, in international relations, and she spent 16 years in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Mexico, rising from a researcher to the head of the Department of North Africa in the Directorate General of Africa and the Middle East. She also served as a professor of migration issues at the Universidad Internacional in Cuernavaca, in the state of Morales, in Mexico, where she lives. In 2002, she decided to change her professional life so as to have more time to focus on her family, retraining and teaching Spanish as a foreign language. In 2008, she began to teach Spanish in Second Life and now runs her personal teaching project, Spanish with Eugenia, in central Chobo, not very far from the SLMOOC headquarters. Among her online activities are her Facebook page and her blog. And if both of these will be in the chat, both of these links will be in the chat log, and they'll also be available in Second Life and on the card that we made for the headquarters. And that will have the note card will have the links to her blogspot and her Facebook page as well as some more information and some tutorials and some other things. So thank you all for joining us here. We're going to put the slurl into the chat log and come and join us in Second Life. And we'll see you there.
Well, we can start with this presentation. Thank you for your introduction, Nancy, in WISIQ. I prefer to present, to show this slideshow, this lecture here in Second Life. So we can see the world, we can work here in world, and at the same time, you see the slideshow, okay? I am going to explain, we are going to see some images, and I hope you enjoy this presentation. And what else? Well, nothing more. Let's start with the presentation. Thank you all of you for joining me here. I'm sorry, my cat is here near me, so if you listen meow, it's my cat. Okay. My presentation here in WISIQ and Second Life is titled Second Life as a Tool for Spanish Teaching. I am going to talk about how I use Second Life to teach Spanish. I am a Spanish teacher, and here in Second Life, also in real life. But for now, I am working, I am focused my activities here in Second Life. Second Life. So let me show how I use Second Life. So the introduce the lecture, Second Life as a Tool for Spanish Teaching. I am going to talk about my project, Spanish with Eugenia. I am going to answer that question on the blackboard, why Second Life? You are going to know the answer of if it is possible to recreate a class in Second Life. I am going to talk about the different tools we can use here. Avatars, books, screens, whiteboards, animation, gesture, words, buildings. Also, we can use Second Life and social networks, video sites and cultural websites. So, yeah, we can work together, okay? I am going to talk about some activities we do here in Second Life, cultural activities, artistic activities, to help the language classes. Also, I am going to talk about a funny activity we do here. I have done here in Second Life, the theater workshop. and some collaboration with other scenes, other places in Second Life. And then I am going to give a summary. Okay, let's start with my project. You are here in my land. Maggie, Nancy, gave me this place to offer my project to anyone who wants to study Spanish. You can see on the blackboard, well, you can see the place, we are at the place, but for you, the new, who doesn't know my place, this is some pictures. We are right now at the main plaza, the land point. Here, when you arrive here to my land, you can see some important information, some information about my classes. Here, if you can see, I am using a pointer on the board. The visitors, students can see the schedule, information about the classes I am giving at the week. In the other pictures, there are some boards. Those boards are material for the different classes, for the levels. So if the student or people interested in classes, they can touch the boards, the green arrows especially, and they can see the material we use at the class. All the classes are focused on grammar, and the material has the grammar and exercises. Of course, when we take a class, we can use some exercises at the book. The books or the information have the student. They can check the material. They can study before the class. And at the class, we work. We can speak more, or we can see maybe a movie, or we can sing a song. All the classes, all the material are focused in a specific topic. So for the people interested who visit here, this place, my place, well, they can see the material we use at the class. Mm-hmm. The next page, in page number 4, we have more pictures about this place. We have a cultural plaza, a very, very small cultural plaza. In that plaza, it is in front of this, of the main plaza. I put some slides, some information about the cultural activity. It depends of the schedule. I can talk about a historic event, especially in Mexico. I am from Mexico, and I can offer information about history of Mexico, or maybe a writer, or maybe a specific topic. For now, there is a exhibition about Día del Niño, the Day of the Kids, and all of the information is in Spanish. So this is another activity, other event we can use to practice Spanish. All the activities I organize are focused in practice Spanish. Mm-hmm. We have rock. It's a rock to have conversation with the student. If we want to have maybe a relaxed class, we can talk here on the grass. Or maybe we can invite other person to talk, to have conversation. The formal classes are on the classroom. Uh-huh. Here is the classroom on the sky. Here we have the classroom inside and another view of the classroom. The classroom are in the sky because sometimes, well, it is good to have some privacy for the class, because, you know, in Second Life, maybe some people is not good or are bad person or, well, how can I say, mischievous person, so they can disturb the class. I take care of the class, I take care of the student to have a relaxed class, of course, a private class, not to have any disturb situation at the class. So that is the reason the classroom are at the Skype. For now, the classroom is open. Generally, I have a security system. Only the student can access to the classroom. Okay, if other person don't belong to the class, doesn't belong to the class, but they don't, the system eject any person. Of course, I have here beside me on the wall, I have a board with information, with a warning, so be careful, you can't go to the classroom because you are going to be ejected. So please, sorry if you are ejected. Okay, so we protect the class, okay, to the students. So this is my project. I offer classes to the students. This is the place. Here we are at the main plaza, with the place with the information. At the sky we have the classroom. And well, in front of this place we have the cultural plaza to have some cultural information, especially Mexico, because I am Mexican. Okay, what else? Why Second Life? Why am I using Second Life? Here in Mexico, in Cuernavaca, we have the languages school and Spanish school have had problems with the crisis, okay, economic crisis, and some of us, the teachers, lost our jobs. So one way to continue working and to continue having money, some friend of mine suggests me to work in Second Life. I didn't know Second Life. I didn't know the virtual world. But someday a friend of mine suggests me to work in Second Life. Why Second Life? Because it's an immersive world. Mm-hmm. One of the main environment to help students to learn Spanish is the immersive world, the immersive environment. In real life, we organize cultural activities, we organize parties, also we organize exhibitions. We travel. In this case, in my city or near the city, to help to live with Spanish. Okay, so Second Life offers us that opportunity. Mm-hmm. This is an immersive world. So we can have a classroom, we can have field trips, role play games, like in real life, cultural and artistic activities. So we can recreate an educational environment here inside Second Life. Better in Second Life, because, well, it is one of the best virtual worlds exist. So the Second Life is an opportunity to recreate that immersion environment and to let us, Spanish teacher, to continue working. Mm-hmm. Because in real life, the situation could be hard. We work only on vacation breaks, or in summer vacation or Christmas vacation. Me, for example, I work all the year. Well, sometimes I take my vacation, of course, but I can work all the time. It depends on me, the hours I can stay here in Second Life. Of course, this is a serious project, and I stay here in Second Life a lot of time. So you can find me here in Second Life. So that is the reason we use Second Life. Can recreate an educational environment. We can get the immersive environment we need to practice a language. If you can see, here we have a classroom in these features. In this feature, we have our theater workshop, a play with the student. We can see movies in Spanish, of course, or the language we are studying. We can participate in special activities here on the feature I am pointing. We participate in the SL10B, the anniversary of Second Life. So at the anniversary of Second Life, we can participate also, well, of course, talking about the Spanish classes. And in this feature, we organize here a lecture, a special lecture about the topic of women, the International Women's Day. So we can do all of that here in Second Life. That is the reason I am working in Second Life. Okay, what else? Is it possible to recreate a class in Second Life? Yes, it is possible. As I said, as you can saw, we have a lot of tools to study a language, to learn. We have classroom. Argument, a conversation about the traditional way to teach. Okay. Yes, we can. I use a traditional material, okay, but I can't help that traditional class. I mean, using a classroom, having some chairs at the classroom, or using a book, build a traditional. But we can share, we can mix this traditional with other way to teach, okay? I mean, having field trips, like I said, or having even parties, yeah, why not? SL Second Life is to have fun, but we can have fun and learn at the same time. So here, for example, in this feature in the middle, yeah, they're very funny, exactly. And the field trips, of course. And we talk when we make a field trip here in Second Life. We can visit some interesting places, cultural places, artistic places. It's a Second Life, of course. It's another world we can use to practice Spanish. Of course, Second Life, the main language is English. And that helps. That helps for me. But we have a Latin community. Okay, so we can have friends, Spanish speaker friends, and then we can practice with our friends. Or some of my students, sometimes they are a couple, their partner, and they maybe a English speaker partner and a Spanish speaker, and they practice the language together. Okay, so that helps also for the class. The relationships helps for the class also. Okay. We can use a lot of tools here in Second Life. Okay. Having a lecture here in this photo, this is a carnival event we did in another sim. There is a sim, Spanish Speak or Instituto Español. Instituto Español all the time is organizing events for the people who wants to practice the language, who wants to practice the Spanish language. So this is the carnival. Here we have a classroom in this photo. In Plaza Luna, also in Spanish speak, they organize all the time parties and musical activities. They help the people to practice the language. In this picture, we have organized, I organized here a play with my student. They act, they can perform, they perform. Of course, of the plays we perform are in Spanish. Or there are scenes here with animation when we can practice some situation. Asking for food or asking for, in a restaurant, for example, all of that is let us to practice the language. What else? Tools. Some of the tools we can use here to learn to practice a language. The tools we can use are avatars, virtual books, screens and whiteboards, animation, gesture, note cards, words, and construction. I am going to talk about that a little. For example, well, here we have the avatars, here we have the books, here also are the books, and the note cards. For example, all my students have material for the class all the time. I have print some virtual books. In the books we have the grammar information, some exercises, oral or writing information. We can use Second Life like in real life. Okay, the students have the material, they can study before the class. If I ask for homework, we can use the note cards. The note cards we can write. Yes, exactly. It's IntelliBook. This is the IntelliBook system. Yes, IntelliBook is a very good, very, very good tool. I print the books, I send the books, you have the books, you can see the books on the screens and study preview to the class. And sometimes if it is not, if the student needs the slide in real life, I send the slide by email. I can send the information by email, the material, so they can have the information, the material for the class here in Second Life with the books in IntelliBook or with in slide by email. Okay, now let's talk about avatars. It's very important. Our avatars are very important in the processing of teaching, in the process of teaching. Very, very important. We play, okay? One way to learn a language is playing. So, yeah, exactly. Maggie, Nancy, load some videos about my classes, and that is very good. Thank you, Maggie. Thank you very much. Okay, very important, the avatars. Okay, with avatars, we get the presence, the presentiality. Okay, we can have our presence here like a teacher and students. And we have that contact. Okay, so sometimes I forgot I am in real life, and then my avatar is working, is teaching. The student are working at the class. We are doing something or having an activity, having a field trip. So we use our avatars. They represent us here in world, in Second Life. So very, very important. We feel inside the world, okay? And another important thing is the avatar can play. Our avatar play. We played, okay, here in the world. We can perform a different... Welcome of the visitors. We can play without being criticized or being judged. We feel comfortable working here. We in Second Life, people in Second Life love to play. Okay, so we can play role-play games, or we can perform. Doesn't matter if our avatar is a robot or a monster or an animal, an object. No, we play. And as we play, we can learn a language and learn Spanish. Mm-hmm. So you can see some pictures. Here is in a cultural exhibition. This is our friend Wilson Boyd, Ross Bronson. He is the owner of the project Spanish Speak, or Instituto Español Second Life. Here, one of our friends is a monster. In this picture, we are performing a play. The students are performing a play. We can create scenarios to perform the plays. Of course, all the texts in the plays are in Spanish, so they can practice their Spanish acting, playing. It's very funny. And here it was a party at Instituto Español Second Life. They organized a lot of activities to practice with Latin, with Spanish speaker friends. So if you have the opportunity to, or if you want to practice your Spanish, visit Instituto Español or the Land Spanish Speak, and you can find a Spanish speaker over there. Okay, of course, we hope to have visitors, Spanish speakers here also, and we can practice the language also. Mm-hmm. Okay, more about the avatars. It helps to reduce the anxiety. Mm-hmm. When we are learning a language or while taking a class, we are nervous. Okay. When we work here in Second Life, the anxiety, the nervousness is decreased. How we feel more comfortable. We can work better. Okay, we can practice here in Second Life. How we feel comfortable. Doesn't matter if we have mistake. Well, because the mistake is not our mistake, the real person is the avatar's mistake. So we are not guilty if we have a mistake. But don't worry. In the classes, of course I correct the pronunciation. I explain about the grammar. But if we have mistake, doesn't matter. So the idea is to talk, to work. Of course, always I am going to correct or I am going to, if you pronounce bad word, I am going to repeat the word with the correct pronunciation. And then the avatars, our avatars works at the class. And we, the real person, we feel better. I can talk about myself. I mean, I am speaking English. And I hope you understand my English. In real life, I can speak English, yes, but it is hard. Thank you. It is a little hard for me. I don't speak as fluently as I do here in real life, in Second Life. So I have the courage to speak in English. Here in Second Life, I feel more comfortable speaking English. In real life, well, a little less. But I do, of course. Thank you. Okay, so that is the reason avatars are very important here in Second Life, and that is the reason we use Second Life to practice our language, okay, to take a class. Okay, let's... Excellent, yeah, of course, sí, tú también. Tú también estás hablando en español, Maggie. Okay, what else about tools, screen and whiteboards? One way to explain the class is to show the material, okay? And here in Second Life, we have a lot of screen and whiteboards, a lot of tools, a lot of screen to explain, to offer the information. You can see here in this slide, here at the class, we are using this whiteboard, some boards to see pictures. Here we have a lecture also. In other sims, our friends, Latin friends, they offer classes about different topics, and they use also screens. Here we are seeing a movie, a video about a cultural activity. And if you can see, this is a picture of this sim. Beside to the right, well, my right, we have these boards, these whiteboards. The student can touch the board, can change the slide, can see the information. But this is just part of the boards. There are a lot of boards in Second Life we can use. There are a lot of scripts to use boards. Very, very interesting. A slideshow, change in the images. So we have a lot of material. A lot of material here in Second Life to work, like in real life. And I think better, like in real life. Yeah, the electronic devices we can use. I love that material. Okay, what else? Gesture and animations. Well, to learn a language, we have to, yes, exactly. We have to feel the language, okay? When we talk about feelings or physical movement, we in real life, teachers are actors. So we perform, we dance, we jump, we have different faces to show feelings. In Second Life, we can do that also. Mm-hmm. The animation on the furniture, that help the animation helps for the class. For example, here we are talking, we are practicing the progressive form. We are dancing. Estamos bailando. Okay, we are singing in Spanish, of course. Estamos cantando here in these pictures. I am happy, for example. I am happy here. I am angry. I am surprised. All that gesture in our avatars or animation of the furniture of our avatars, all of that helps for the class. Okay, we can say giving or having a movement and talking about the movement we are doing. So it helps for the class. Some scenarios in Second Life, they have a lot of animation. Here in this house, in these pictures, all the furniture have animation, so we can talk about being sitting or taking a shower here in these pictures, or cooking, or having a or sleeping, for example, having a shower here. Of course, not naked. This is a PG sim, so we can have naked pictures, of course. Okay, so well, imagine Eugenia is taking a shower. So we're talking about the activities, the routine. We have a special class about routine. Okay, we talk about having a shower, a special topic in Spanish. Okay, and we have that animation in these pictures. At the seams, at the stores, of furnitures, we can use the stores also to use the animation. Well, sometimes the owners ask me, why am I here, if I need something or want to buy something. Well, some, not exactly. I am using the places for practice. Okay, so that is the reason we use Second Life. Okay, gesture and animation. What else? Buildings. Other way to learn a language is using or talking about cultural tradition. Mm-hmm. For example, in Spanish speak, they have they create buildings, special buildings. Here is a museum. Here is the Spanish speak or Instituto Español. And here is the mi casa es su casa, sim, my house is your house. Here is my last classroom. Okay, not now, but this is my last classroom. And this is a store. It's a store, a Mexican, the owner is Mexican. And they built a special building in real life. All of that buildings are buildings in real life. Okay, so the builder, the Latin builders, have created all that places to learn Spanish, specifically to learn Spanish. Other schools, language, English school or French school or other group, education group, they have created their own building, their own copies. Okay, in Instituto Español, they have a lot of buildings. Well, I think it's one of the best Latin or the better Latin school in Second Life. Mm-hmm. So, well, you can visit those places, or you can visit this my small place. Yeah, he is not here. I think he crashed. But yeah, I think, yeah, Wilson Boyd is the owner of Instituto Español. You can visit his place. It's a very wonderful place. Yeah, he's off. But I think he'll come back. Okay, other tools. We like teachers, or me, for example, we can't, and a lot of teachers do. Not me. Not only me. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's here, Wilson is coming. At the same time we work in Second Life, we can work with other tools, see, social networks, video sites, music websites, cultural websites, wikis, blogs, internet is a wonderful tool to learn. Okay, I use the social networks to advertise my classes, to advertise my project, like others do, of course. And in Facebook, you can find me in Facebook, in YouTube. I have some videos in YouTube also, small videos, okay, not perfect videos, but we have. Google, we use Google, the Google Calendar, the Google document, all that information helps to the class. Okay, we can live here in Second Life and play in Second Life and practice the language, and also we can have contact in the social networks or using the wiki places to have a investigate, to research about a specific topic. Sometimes I ask my advanced student to research about that topic, and then they look the information and they can come back to the class and talk about that, always for of course in Spanish. Mm-hmm. Exactly, yeah. Mm-hmm. I have to work more in my videos. I promise to do more videos. What else? Cultural activities. Other way to practice a language is to live the language, to live the culture of Latin countries, Latin people. In Instituto Español, when I work in that place, we organize different cultural activities. The Day of the Dead, here in these pictures, we have an altar here. The International Women Day, in these pictures. Here we were working about the Mexican Revolution. Mm-hmm. I frequently offer lectures about historic actors in Mexico, in the history of Mexico. This is another picture of a carnival organized at Instituto Español and in Spanish speak. So we have opportunities, a lot of opportunities to live the language, okay? In this case, well, Mexico, well, I focus my activities in Mexico because I am Mexican, but well, there are more teachers can use this second life talking about their countries, their tradition, their history. So that is the reason Second Life is a good tool to teach, okay? We can recreate all that scenarios to read Spanish, to know this the language, to know the tradition, and that is another way to learn a language, okay? And more, here we can see the exhibition, the Instituto Español, the Spanish Speaking Organized, the Day of the Dead here, for example, Day of the Dead here also. Yes, exactly. Yeah, exactly. It is hard and it is cheaper. It is cheaper to recreate the cultural parties, the cultural events here in Second Life. For example, there are Mexican builders who create all that material. Okay, well, some of us, sometimes we don't know to build too much, okay? But there is people who can build. And we can buy, because we have to buy, all that material. It's not expensive. We can invest money building, paying a rent, buying different material, clothes, for example. In Mexico, well, the people I know, the builder, the designer, they create a lot of things for us. I use a lot of, here in this place, in Spanish with Eugenia place, I have a lot of objects of Mexicans. They have created these things, not me. I have to buy. Okay? I teach, not a good builder, so I have to buy. So, well, here is the Instituto Español also. Why I talking about Instituto Español Spanish Speak? Because in that place, they made a lot of wonderful things. Mm-hmm. They build, they decorate, they have a lot of things. If you want to visit this place, visit, go to that place, it's very, very good. Always have a different buildings, a different decoration, a different scenarios, and all with the idea to practice Spanish, okay? And here in my small place, well, I can offer you some information in Spanish on cultural exhibition to talk about cultural activities in Mexico, okay? What else? Well, we talk about, I offer, most of the time I offer some, well, sometimes I offer some lectures about history events, social events, parties in Mexico, especially. I love to talk about that. In Spanish, my lectures about cultural, historic, or artistic event, or literature information are in Spanish all the time. Okay, I speak about the topic, of course, slowly. The idea is to help my student to hear the language, to try to understand slowly, and that is another way to help. They can listen the Spanish at the same time they are learning about history or cultural or literature. Okay. Well, let me change. I was talking about artistic activities. Well, yes, concert, DJ set. Sometimes, if we have if we feel okay, we can sing. Why not? I am not a good singer, but why not? In one of my other classes, we can sing. We can have karaoke. Why not in a party? Okay, why not in a party? We have fun, and then the same time we can practice our Spanish. Okay. Yeah, no, me neither. Oh, sorry, me either. Okay, the other workshop, very fast, because we almost finished. One of our activities, a funny activity I practice with my students, is the place, the theater. I have had some theater, some plays. We have performed some plays, me or with my student or only the student. Yes, exactly. Can you see this girl here in this picture? Here, the pointer, red there. This girl. Guess who is? Who is she? Well, those are pictures about exactly is Maggie. That actor is Maggie. Mm-hmm. She was drunk. Mm-hmm, exactly. Sorry. And sometimes without not too much clothes. I'm sorry, Maggie, for that. And this, okay, without clothes. Well, not naked. Without few clothes. Yes, exactly. Cover your eyes. Okay. Here in this picture, we were working about a play, talking about office situation at the work. Here we were talking about here this place was a little hard because the text is a poetry text, a little hard to understand. Exactly. Yeah, oh my God. Yeah. The husband was not happy about that. Okay, all of that are plays we perform in Second Life. We can build these scenarios. Uh-huh. Student read this, the text, the script. They learn, they understand the text, and they perform, they repeat the Spanish, but also they can feel the feelings in the text. Okay, so that way we practice our Spanish in the place. Very, very funny, very, very funny, and very interesting activity. Okay, now let me change the slide. Talk about collaborative action. Well, maybe not exactly collaborative. I think I am not exactly a spy. I mean, I use different scenarios here in Second Life, especially the Latin, the Spanish speaker scenarios. Mm-hmm. Some of these places are here in Second Life. Some of them are not. They have gone, disappear, but all the time we have a Latin scenario. Okay, we can visit that places. They have an exhibition also. Maybe they have a party. Here, for example, is a Spanish place. The owner is a Spanish girl from Spain, and they speak a little different, so we can talk with them, with the owners. Here is Opera Joven. Opera Joven is a Latin place also. We can find Spanish speakers here. Universo Creativo is another. We can find a Spanish speaker, and we can get friends, partner to speak. And also here, for example, here is a specific exhibition. Mm-hmm. Some friend of us, he create a special world, environment world about ecological world environment, and he offer us an explanation about his space in Spanish, of course. I invite my students, if they have the opportunity to join me in this activity, to listen. Okay, not only to listen my Spanish, they can listen other Spanish speaker, and then with that activity they can practice also the language. So well, I use terrible. I use all the Latin places I can can help me to practice the language. Okay, so that title, collaborative action, well, maybe it's using action or abuse action, or I'm sorry, well, we use that places, not only my place, other places to practice the language. Okay, very fast. En mi casa es su casa is a specific place to, yes, exactly, taking advantage of that. Yeah, exactly, hitting cheat walls. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, okie dokie. Mm-hmm. Excellent. Oh, excellent. Excellent. Okay, I can continue then. Okay, with calm. Mi casa es su casa. It's a special place. The owner is a Spanish teacher in the United States. He has created this place to practice Spanish. If you can visit this place, if you want to practice, play some games and practice Spanish, here in Mi casa es su casa, we have a lot of devices, a lot of tools to practice games, scenarios. It's a very interesting place. I use all the time this place. In my program, I have visits in this place to practice. Other places, well, here I don't have enough features. I mean, there are more places, Latin places, Spanish speaker places we can visit to practice the language. Machu Picchu is a theme created by one university in Peru. They have created this place. They have the place is very beautiful. They have exhibition also. They have material, some gift. Exactly, that very good Spanish. Exactly, yeah. You can. I am not talking about only me, the activities I do. No, there are a lot of places you can go and learn Spanish and practice Spanish and use, yeah, exactly, and use Second Life to learn Spanish, to learn other languages, of course, but in this case, Spanish, okay? Yeah, Second Life is a wonderful tool to teach and to learn Spanish. Mm-hmm. To finish this presentation, let me say a summary, to offer a summary. Okay, we were talking about the good things of Second Life. Mm-hmm. We can use gestures, avatar, building, animation. We can have field trips. We can have Spanish speaker friends, Spanish speaker partners to practice the language. We can have that immersive environment to practice a language to recreate real life in Second Life. Yeah, good, very good, very, very good. But we have some problems, okay? Or some situation to which doesn't help to the class. Okay, let me talk about that. But we can save that. But what happened? What are the problems we can have here in virtual worlds? For example, technical issues. Mm-hmm. To work in Second Life, we need to have a good computer. Second Life is a very heavy program. Mm-hmm. Me, for example, my computer, I have to load, to upgrade my computer to use a very good software, okay, hardware and software for my computer to work better, to avoid lag, to work with better movement here in Second Life. And some of the students don't have a good computer, so we can be frozen sometimes, or the voice can change, or we crash because of our computers. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh, exactly. Uh-huh. So to work better in Second Life, we have to have a very good computer. Okay, so that is maybe the internet connection is good in your place, or maybe the climate crash our internet connection. So sometimes we lost the voice, or we crash, we disappear from Second Life. But we can fix that with using another kind of viewers. Live viewers, for example, Google Hangouts, exactly, other environments, Skype, we can use Skype if we lost voice in Second Life, we can use Skype, for example, mm-hmm. Google Talk, exactly, we have more tools to have like a plan B, okay, if we have problems. Yeah, me too. Sometimes I have problems. I crash. But I try, I have a fast internet connection. Most of the time I'm here. I don't have too much problems because I am the teacher, I have the project, and my computer has to be okay, and my internet connection has to be okay. Okay? But sometimes my students have problems. Okay, and that is not exactly good, but well, the technology is changing very fast, and we can fix that situation soon. Second Life as a game. Well, yes, most the people see Second Life a game, a place to have fun, to join, and they don't see seriously the Spanish classes, okay? But when they discover our project, our education project, well, they can see if it is possible to work, to learn a language in Second Life. So that is, well, for the first time, it is not good because the people who come to Second Life, well, just want to play. Okay, don't want to take a class. But when they discover, well, they take his class, daily class. So that is good for me. Logos of the classes. Well, that is not exactly a bad situation. It's a good situation. My classes, the classes are cheap. And sometimes are free, but we can get our money. Mm-hmm. If we have more students, if I have one student, well, less money for me, but if I have more, the money I can get is more, and that is good. It is good for me. Okay, but it is good to have cheap classes. You can take student can take their language classes cheap for less money. Preview to maybe you have to travel to a Spanish speaker country. So before to your travel, you can take your classes here in Second Life, cheap classes. And when you go to your visit, your travel, well, you have the more practice. You can understand better at your visit or maybe at your activity, your work activity, maybe the visit for working. And if you take first your Spanish classes here, in virtual classes or in Second Life, well, that is good. It is good for you. Differences in time zone. Yes, sometimes that is not a good idea because I have a schedule. Mm-hmm. Maybe some people from Australia or from the Middle East or from Japan went to have a class, and when they are the day I am on my bed, and that is could be a little hard. But well, I am flexible. I am flexible with the schedule, and most of the time, my student and me, we schedule a convenient time for us. Okay, a good time for me, a good time for my student. So could be a little difficult, but not terrible. Not terrible. We can fix it. So, well, that way is that is my presentation. That is the Second Life as a tool for Spanish teacher. I think, well, for language teacher, any kind of language, there are teacher, a lot of teachers teaching English, French, Spanish, other topics. Exactly, exactly. Yeah, that is good. Mm-hmm. Yep. If you have some question, please you can write your question in local chat, and I can answer you, your question. Well, with this is my presentation. Thank you. Thank you very much, all of you, to listen me, and I hope you can understand my English. Sorry. Thank you, and I hope it helps you to discover to use in a different way Second Life. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you. Great, excellent. Great, excellent. Thank you, Maggie. Thank you, Ajil, Sabia, thank you. Monja, thank you. Thank you, and well, let me change my... Here you can find my network. Mm-hmm. I am in Facebook, in Google Plus, in YouTube, in Spanish, my blog in Spanish with Eugenia. So you can see me in that place. I'm sorry, let me see your question. Well, there is good things in both ways, but Second Life is better. It's better. Like I said, we feel comfortable. We play, okay, and we can have our class, like a friend of mine say, in our pajamas. Ah, excellent! Very good. Oh yeah, I need that. Strategies, I need that. could be in Linden's, could be in USD. To pay the classes, there are two ways. PayPal system or Linden's in Second Life. If we use PayPal system, they pay me in real life, in our account, in real life, in PayPal system. But yeah, I can accept Linden's because I have to use Linden's here in Second Life. I have to pay my things. Mm-hmm. Let me see. Mm-hmm. Yes, I will move in. Okay, yeah, here we are working in, well, all the levels. Well, I teach in basic, intermediate, and advanced. I have classes, basic, intermediate, and advanced. Very basic also, very, very, for very, very beginners, I have a course. Okay. Thank you very much, Ajil. Thank you for your notice, Sabia. Thank you. I am going to consider that. Mm-hmm. And to preview to a course, a class. All the time, I ask the interested people in classes. Great, excellent. okay. Yeah, exactly. Okay, I speak English and you Spanish. Mm-hmm. Great. Well, yeah, we can have a intercambio. well, to talk about business in English, well, maybe it could be a little hard for me. Klingon classes, that will be great. Will be great. Well, that it will be interesting to have Klingon glasses. Oh, that is good. Very good. Very good. Mm-hmm. Very, very good. Esperanto. Oh my God. Esperanto. Klingon, Spanish, English, French. Exactly. Exactly. Yeah, we can learn. Here we can learn a lot of things. And I was not participating, visiting, listening some lecture about the how to use the TICs, is TICs in Spanish, the new technologies in education. And I think Spanish, Second Life is part of that new technology to teach. So it is good to use Second Life. It is good to use to have virtual classes, to work with, to use internet, to learn. Okay, I learn a lot. I am not a native user, okay, digital native or indigenous native, how can I say that in English? Nativos digitales in Spanish. And for me, it is a little hard to use some tools, new technological tools. Digital native, yeah, exactly. I am not a digital native, so it is hard. But then the young people, and well, foreign people also, they from United States, for example, Europe, they know more to use how to use the new technologies. So they like to take your classes here using Second Life or another virtual course because they know how to use it. Mm-hmm. And that helps for me, for my class. Well, do you have any other question? It's okay. Okay, yeah, you can continue writing in local chat. Yeah, if you want. Yeah. So, yeah, Second Life is a great tool to teach. Very, very great tool to teach. And there are more virtual worlds. And I hope in the future I can use other virtual worlds and have my project in other worlds. Thank you, Ayil. Thank you, Ayil, for coming. Yeah, it's meat for meat. Yes, exactly. I am hungry too. Also.
Oh, that was great. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ayil. Gracias, Maggie. Thank you, Maggie. And we'll see you in the MOOC, of course, in the other classes.